Hello friends, welcome to the today's session. In today's session, we'll be discussing practical number 6, that is determination of frequency of AC mains. Okay, this is the title of the experiment, determination of frequency of AC mains. The aim of the practical, it is to determine the frequency of AC mains by using sonometer and vibrating wire. Okay, so first of all, we will see what are the apparatus which are required in this experiment. The apparatus which are required in this experiment is the sonometer, a step-down transformer, slotted weights, and two strong bar magnets with the connecting wires. Okay, first of all, we'll see what is the experimental setup. In the experimental setup, you can see the schematic diagram of this experiment is shown over here, in which you can see a 230 volt AC supply. It is given to the step down transformer, and the output of the step down transformer, it is taken one output, it is given to the one end of the wire, and another output of the transformer, it is given to the another end of the wire. This wire is fixed between the two knife edges B1 and B2. Okay, in between these two knife edges, two magnets are placed with a north pole and south pole of two magnets facing each other, so that there will be a magnetic field perpendicular to the direction of the current. Okay, so and other end of the wire, it is loaded with this load. Okay, for now, what we will do, we will see the experimental setup and then we will see. See, that is the 230 volt AC supply which we have given to this transformer. This is a step down transformer. Okay, and the one terminal of this step down transformer, one end of the step down transformer, it is connected to the one end of the wire, and this wire, it is going over this knife edges. Okay, and in between these two knife edges, magnets are placed. Okay, so that if the current is flowing in this direction, these magnets will be applying a magnetic field perpendicular to the flow of the current. Okay, and this wire is going in this fashion over this pulley. And you can see from this one, this is a pulley. And through this pulley, it is going up to this point, and the other end of this wire, it is fixed with a load of 500 gram. And the other terminal of the transformer, it is connected at this point, so that you will be having a circuit in this fashion. Okay, that way your current is flowing. Okay, so this is the basic experimental setup is there. Now, what is the principle behind this experiment, that I will explain, and then we will try to carry out the experiment. Okay, so the basic principle of this experiment is that whenever the current is flowing through this wire, okay, magnetic field is applied on this conductor. So due to this magnetic field and current, the electromagnetic force will be experienced by this wire, and it will vibrate with a certain amount of magnitude if the length of the wire is adjusted in a such a way that its natural vibrational frequency is equal to the applied frequency of the wire. Okay. Now, in this case, if you see the frequency of AC mains, it has the formula n is equal to 1 upon 2l root t upon m. Okay, so if I say that n is the frequency of the AC mains which I have applied, and t is the tension applied to the string, then as I increase the tension, the frequency for a given wire, the frequency for a given supply, a frequency of AC is constant. Okay, so from this one, I can say that the tension in the string and the length of the wire, they are directly proportional to each other. If I transfer this term from this side to this side, I can say that length of the wire is directly proportional to the tension. So if I increase the tension applied to the wire, my vibrating length, it will increase. Okay, so we have to calculate this vibrating length for the given wire, and by plotting this graph, we have to calculate the frequency of AC by using this formula. Okay, so first of all, we'll see the observation table. The observation table, it contains, it is given that mass per unit length of the wire, it is given, which is 1.870. It has been given in terms of gram per meter, which has been converted into gram per centimeter, which is a CGS unit. Okay, the first column in the observation table, it is giving you the mass attached to the wire. In this case, the hanger which we have provided, it is having a mass of 500 grams. Okay. So first of all, what we will do, we will consider the perform the experiment with the hanger only, which is having a mass of 500 gram. I know the value of the acceleration due to gravity, which is 980. So if I do this simple calculation, 500 into 980, that will come out to be 490,000. So my tension in the string, it will be 490,000. Okay, this will be the my tension. I have to take a square root of this one. So if I just suppress a square root, so my I'll get the value 700. So my first reading, it will be for square root of tension, it will be 700. Now what we will be doing, we will be calculating this resonating length now. Okay, so for this purpose, what I'll do, I'll just switch on this transformer. You can see from this indicator, now this transformer is switched on. Okay, now we will adjust the length of this wire in a such a way that we will adjust the length of this wire in a such a way that this wire will vibrate with a maximum amplitude. For your sake of understanding purpose, what I'll do, I'll keep a paper rider on this one. I'll keep a paper rider on this one, and I'll try to adjust this length of this wire so that the wire will vibrate with maximum amplitude. Okay, now see, I'm adjusting this length now so that this wire will vibrate with a maximum amplitude. Okay, now this paper rider has fallen down. Okay, now wire is vibrating with a maximum amplitude. As this is a sonometer, so you can also hear this noise. You can hear this noise as this wire is vibrating. You can hear this noise. Okay, now we have to calculate this vibrating length. So if you see the vibrating length, how to calculate this vibrating length, you can see this sonometer, it has been provided with a marking from 0 to 100. It has been provided with a marking from 0 to 100. So what we will be doing, we will be taking the position, we will be noting down the position of the first, we will be noting down the position of the first bridge, which is approximately 20 centimeter. In this case, it is 20 centimeter. Okay. And similarly, I'll be moving to this position. Okay. I'll be moving to this position, and which if you calculate, it will be 67.2. It is 67.2. Now, what we will do, 67.2 minus 20. 67.2 minus 20. If I do this subtraction, I'll get this length around 47.2. So my first reading, it will be 47.2 centimeter. This will be in terms of centimeter. So that is the first reading. So I have adjusted this wire initially so that I'm having the vibrations in this fashion. We can see these vibrations from this one, from this position. Okay, now we will adjust this knife edges in a such a way that we will have a maximum vibrations. Now you can see over here, in this case I am getting a steady and maximum vibration. Again, I'll calculate this reading, it is coming out to be around same 20, and this is 67 exactly. So if I calculate this 67 minus 20, it is coming around 47. So my next reading, it will be 47.0. So I have to take a mean of this one, which will be L in terms of centimeter. Okay, so 47 plus 47.2, and if I divide it by 2, 47.2 plus 47 is equal to divided by 2. If I do this, it is coming out to be 47.1. Okay, it is coming out to be 47.1. Now, next, what we have to do is this. We have to calculate the root t by L value. So, what is value of root t? It is 700. So, now what I'll do, I'll just try to calculate 700 divided by L, which is, what is the value of L? It is 47.1, and it is coming out to be 14.86. That is my first root t by L value. Okay, now what we will do now, we will adjust the load in the wire. Okay, so this is the load which we will be applying now. The weight of this load is 50 gram. Now we will be applying this load to this hanger. Okay, so this hanger I am applying. So initially it was 50 gram. Now this is plus 50. So total weight which I have applied over here, it is now 550 gram. So in this case, now my next reading, it will be 550 gram. Now if you observe this, okay, if you observe this, I'll again keep this paper rider on this one. Okay, I'll again keep this paper rider on this wire. Okay, so that you can get whether the wire is vibrating. Now you can see that the wire is not vibrating now. Okay, now what we will do, we will try to adjust this length of the wire in a such a way that it will start vibrating. Okay, now, yeah. Now you can carefully watch this. The wire is vibrating with a maximum amplitude. And you can note down this, you can hear also this, you can listen this sound as well. Okay, so wire is vibrating. Now what we will do, we will try to calculate this reading. It is 20 centimeter in this case now. Okay, and on this case it is 70 centimeter. So 70 minus 20, it will be 50 centimeter. Okay, so 50 centimeter. Similarly, I'll try to arrange this knife edges in a such a way that I'll get a maximum amplitude. Okay, so in this case, I'm adjusting it now. Okay, and for this, I'm getting again the maximum vibrations. If you calculate this, it is coming out to be same. So my second reading, it will be 50 again. My second reading is 50 again. Now what we will do, we'll just try to do the calculations. Now the mass which is attached, it is 550 into 10, gravity it is 980. So it is coming out to be 5,39,000. 5,39,000. If I take a square root of this, I'll get 734. I'll get 734.16. Okay. And this is value of root t. And if I take a mean of this 50 and 50, it will come out to be 50 only. So if I divide root t by L, root t is 734.16 divided by value of L, it is 50. So if I do these calculations, I'll get the 14.68. I'll get the 14.68. Now what we will do, I will attach one more 50 gram weight to the wire. Okay. So we will just add one more 50 gram weight to this wire. Okay. Now this initial 50, this 50, so it is 100 gram plus 500 gram, it will be totally 600 gram. Okay. So my next reading, it will be 600 gram. The next reading, it is 600 gram. Now what I'll do, I'll just try to calculate this value, 600 into acceleration due to gravity is 980, so which is coming out to be 5,88,000. I have to take a square root of this, so it will be 766.81. That is this value of root t. Now we will again try to arrange this, try to set the length of the vibrating wire so that it will vibrate with a maximum amplitude. So now here in this case, you can find that wire is vibrating with a maximum amplitude. Okay. And In this case, this reading is 17.5. This is 17.5 and this is 70. Okay. So that is 70 minus 17.5. So it is coming out to be 52.5. Okay. And if I further arrange this, so if I arrange further it for the maximum vibrations, okay. Okay. So now it is coming out to be 17.2. Okay. So 70 minus 17.2, it is coming out to be 52.8. 52.8. So if I take a mean of these two, if I take 52.8 and 52.5, if I take a mean of these two, it will be 105.3 divided by 2. It is coming out to be 52.65. 52.65. Okay. And what we have to do is just root t divided by L we have to calculate. So value of root t is 766.81 divided by value of L, it is 52.65. Okay. So if I just do this division, I'll get a number 14.56. In this way, you have to continue. I'll again attach a one more weight of 50 gram. Okay. I'll attach a one more weight of 50 gram. Okay. I'll attach a one more weight of 50 gram. Now it is 150 plus 500. That will be 650. So my next reading, it is 650 gram. My next reading, it is 65 gram. Now we will try to adjust the length of this wire. Okay. So that the wire will vibrate with a maximum amplitude. So I'll just place a paper rider on this one so that it will be clearly visible to all of us. Okay. Now see, for this length, it is vibrating with a maximum amplitude. Yeah, you can hear the noise made by this wire as well. Okay. Now we will just try to calculate this value. This, in this case, it is 15 centimeter. In this 15 centimeter, and here it is 70 centimeter. This is 70. So 70 minus 15. If you calculate this, it will come out to be 55. It will come out to be 55. If I further adjust it, I'll get the value in the same range. Okay. For maximum amplitude, I'm just adjusting this one. For maximum amplitude, okay. Now it is vibrating with a maximum amplitude. In this case, it is reading is 15 centimeter. Here in this case, it is 70.3. So it is 70.3 minus 15. So it is coming out to be 55.3. It is 55.3. If I take a mean of these two, 55 divided by 2, it is coming out to be 55.15. It is coming out to be 55.15. And I'll just do this simple multiplication. 650 into 980, it is coming out to be 637,000. 637,000. If I take a square root of this one, it is coming out to be 798. Okay. 0.12. Okay. And just simply, I have to divide it by this root t by L, which is 55.15. So my final reading over here, it is coming out to be 14.47. Now for the last weight, which is 700 gram, what we will do, we will keep this weight on this slot. Okay. So now this is, it is kept 200 weight we have applied, and the hanger mass is 500 gram. So my last reading, it is 700 gram. Now we will try to adjust this length. Okay. So I'll just place a paper rider again. Now you can see for this length, it is vibrating with a maximum amplitude. Yes. You can hear the noise made by this wire. okay, as it is vibrating with a maximum amplitude. Okay, now see, here in this case, that this reading it is 15 centimeter, okay, this is 15 centimeter, and here in this case it is 73 centimeter. So what we will do, 73 minus 15, so it is coming out to be 58 centimeter. It is coming out to be 58 centimeter. If you further adjust for the second reading, it will come out around same, so it is 58 centimeter. If I take a mean of these two, it will be 58 centimeter. Now I just have to simply multiply this 700 into 980, so which is coming out to be 686,000. 686,000. And if I take a square root of this one, I'll get 828.25. If I do this multiple division, root t by l, so I'll get root t divided, which is 828.25 divided by 58. If I do this, it is coming around 40.28. Okay, so in the last column, what you have to do is that for all these values, you have to calculate the mean. Okay, so I'll just add all these five numbers and divide by five. So it is 40.86 plus 14.68 plus 14.56 plus 14.47 plus 14.28. Okay, if I do this multiplication, addition, it is coming out to be 72.85 divided by 5. If I do this, I am getting the mean of 14.57. I am getting a mean of 14.57. Now we will go ahead with the calculations. Okay, we know the relation between the frequency of AC mains and the tension applied to the wire. So the relation is N is equal to 1 upon 2L root T upon M. Okay, so what I'm doing now, just I'm taking this root m outside, so it will be 1 upon 2 into square root of m. This root t I'll keep as it is, and I'll just transfer this l from this side to this side, so it will be divided over here, root t divided by l, and which I'll be taking as a mean value. Now here in this case, we have provided with the mass per unit length of the wire, which is 0.018 7 gram per meter. So what I'll do, I'll just try to calculate this value of the frequency of AC mains by using a calculations. So formula is 1 upon, so 1 divided by, I'll just put a square root of 2, okay, into, this will be root m, so it is root m, value of m is 0.0187, okay, I'll just complete this bracket. Okay, and I'll just calculating this, it is 3.6563. So this value is coming out to be for this factor. Okay, and I have to multiply this factor by root t divided by l, which I have calculated, it is 14.57. So the frequency which I am getting from this result, it is coming out to be 53.27. It is coming out to be 53.27 hertz. And we know that in our daily household application, the signal which we are getting from the electricity board, it is having a frequency which is 50 hertz, and the amplitude it is 230 volts. So our answer must be coming around 50 hertz. So in this case, our answer is coming out to be 53.27 hertz. This is by calculation. Now we have to move with the second part, which is nothing but the plotting of graph between L and root T. We have calculated the values of L, we have calculated the values of root T, we have to calculate, plot this graph of root T versus L, and then we have to calculate its slope, and we have to then find out the value of N by using this value of the slope. So for the sake of plotting the graph, I have taken a graph paper over here. So what I'll do, I'll just try to plot this graph. For this purpose, what I'm doing is this, I just draw a x-axis and y-axis. Let us say this is my y-axis, okay, this is my y-axis, and this is my x-axis, this is my x-axis. Okay, so let us say this is my origin. In this case, this is my y-axis, this is my x-axis. Okay, on x-axis I am taking a value of root t. Okay, if I can, first of all, while plotting any graph, you have to take a scale. Okay, you have to take a scale. On y-axis I am plotting the length, for you have to write down over here what is scale. So scale we will be taking for x-axis, and the scale which I will be taking for a y-axis. Okay, these two scales we will be taking for x-axis and y-axis. Now we have to first of all see what is the value of maximum value of the root t, and the what is the minimum value of the t. If you see over here, the maximum value of the t, it is 828, and the minimum value of the t, it is 700. Okay, it is 700. So I'll just do this simple calculations. 828 minus 700. So if I do this, I'll get a 128 number. Means my scale should be in such a way that I'll be getting this 128. I'll be getting this 128 on this one. Okay. So for this purpose, I'll just measure this number of boxes I'm having on my graph paper. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay. So 15 boxes I am having. If I divide this 128 by 15, I'll be getting 8.53. But it is inconvenient to use this scale. So 1 centimeter is equal to 8.53. Instead of that, what I'll do, I'll go to the with the next approximate integer number, which is 10 Newton or 10 dime. Okay, so 1 centimeter is equal to 10 dime is my scale for the x-axis. Okay, so and my minimum value is starting with the 700. So I'll give this as an 700, then 710, then 720, then 730, 740, 750, 760, 770, 780, 790, 800, then 810, 820, 830, and finally it is 840. Okay, so this way I can go. And on the x-axis, on the y-axis, I am having the value of L. Minimum value of L, it is 47, and maximum value is 58. So if I do 58 minus 47, so I'm coming out to, it is coming out to be 11. So I'll just measure the number of boxes on the y-axis. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Okay. So if I do this for this one, I'll get divided by 22. Okay, so I'll be getting 0.5. So my scale, it is 1 centimeter is equal to 0.5 centimeter. So I'll be starting with the 47. I'll be starting with the 47. So let us say this is 47. Then this will be 47.5. Then this is 48. Okay, then 48.5. Then this will be 49. Then this will be 50. Then this will be 51. This will be 52. I'm not writing the in-between numbers. You can write if you wish. This is 54. This is 55. This is 56. This is 57. And 58, it will come out over here. We are missing with the one digit, but that's okay. Okay. Now we will just try to plot this graph for L equal to 47.1. So 47.1, it will come over here. And the tension for this, it is 700. So my first point, it is coming over here. This is first point. Then 734, it will come out to be somewhere here. And the length is, it is 50 centimeters. So 754, and this will be, so second point, it is coming over here. So similarly, we can go for the this one, 52.5, it will be over here. 65, it will come out to be over here. And the, for the same value, that tension, it is 766, which has come out to be over here. So if I take the intersection of these two, okay, if I take a intersection of these two, it will come out to be over here, okay. And for the next point, you can plot all those points. It is 798, so it will come out to be around over here. And the value of L, it is 55, so it is around over here. So it is 55.15, so it will go over here. So like this. So if I draw a straight line from this one, I can draw a straight line from this one. If I try to connect these points, I can draw a straight line from this one. And the my straight line, it will look like this. Okay, so that is called as a straight line fit to this curve. So it will go in this fashion. We have not plotted the fifth point, but you can take the fifth point and you can plot that as well. Okay, so this is the line we have drawn. Now we have to calculate the slope of this line. So for that purpose, what I'll do, I'll take any two points. So for example, I'll take this point, okay, and I'll take this point. I'll take this point, and we know that the equation of line, okay, it is y is equal to mx. So what is value of m? M is nothing but the slope. So from this one, I can write y is equal to m by x. So here in this case, so if I consider slope, value of y, I'm having the length, so it will be L, and value of x, I'm having the root t, so it is L by root t, that will be my slope. So for this purpose, I just have to note down these coordinates of this point. So this is the 734 point. 734 point. So it is x, it is 734.16, and the second point it is 50. Okay, and for this point it is 798.12, and the second point it is 55.15. And if I calculate the slope of this one, which will be slope is equal to what? Y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. If I calculate this slope, value of y2 in this case it is 798, y2 which is 55.15 minus 50. So I am getting 5.15 divided by, this will be 798.12 minus, this will be 734.16. So it is coming out to be 63.96. If I do this simple calculation, 5.15 divided by 63.96, if I do this, I'm getting this value 0.0805. That will be the value of slope. Now we will go to the calculations by the graph. The equation for this one, it is n is equal to 1 upon 2 root m, t root t divided by L. But in this case, our slope, it is coming out to be L by root t. So I have to take a reciprocal of this one. So it is 1 upon slope. So what I'll do, I'll just simply put this value. So 1 upon 2 into root value of m, it is 0.0187. Okay, into the slope of which I have calculated, it is coming out 0.0805. Okay, if I do this simple calculation, so I'll just do 1 divided by bracket 2 into square root of 0.0187, bracket complete. So I'm calculating this constant into 1 divided by slope, which is coming 0.0805. So in this case, my frequency, it is coming around 45.42. So it is 45.42. Okay. So this way you have to note down these two readings. Okay. So finally, you have to write down in the result the frequency of AC mains by using calculations and frequency of AC mains by using graph. It is coming out to be 45.42.